Hi guys, follow me on Instagram to never ever miss any of my crazy updates.
Hi guys and welcome to another vlog. I'm driving this. This is the Hyundai Accent, Ascent, whatever you want to call it. This car comes courtesy of Durga Car Deco to me. So make sure to click on the link in the pinned comment to give them a follow on Instagram. Anyways, the design of this car is actually quite nice. I had a crush on this when I was small. I'm so stupid. Anyways, let's open the engine bay straight away and oh my god, why is it so heavy? Okay, that is the engine, SOHC 12 valve. There was another engine which was a DOHC 16 valve. There is no insulation here. It didn't need it as such at that time. The design is actually okay. The length is not that much, 4.2 meters or whereabouts. And now obviously the Accent is under 4 meters in length. The size of the wheels is changed into 175, 70, 13. So Hyundai was offering slightly wider tires and Maruti was offering 165s on the S-team. I think so, somewhere whereabouts. Anyways, that does not matter. I like this white color. I like the way they have actually designed the car with black molding, black door handles, black outside rearview mirrors. That time, this was a less premium feature because the higher variants used to get all this body color. Coming to the rear of the car, it used to have this antenna, okay, which retracts from here automatically when you turn on the audio system. This is the Accent GLE, I think, or GLS, does not matter. Clear lens lights, which was again a revolutionary feature. A reverse parking camera has been added here. Where is the exhaust? That time nobody used to do fake exhaust, but the real exhaust is, yeah, you guessed it right, it's not here, it's gone missing. No, there it is, the real exhaust of this car. The boot is decent size for the segment. It was obviously decent size. And here at the rear, there was not much space as such. Actually, the seats are pushed all the way back, but decent amount of space. Now at that time, the Accent was a great seller for Hyundai. They also came up with a diesel engine that was not very reliable at that time, but then Hyundai really improved its engines. And the handling was kind of soft and soggy. That does not matter. What matters is that the door pockets are really big. Do they have road pockets at the rear? No. Hyundai didn't offer it on the Sonata. They did not offer it on the Accent either. So on the equal playing field with its cars, seats seem comfortable to me, but you know, you sit really very low. Dashboard design is actually quite different because it gets this grey treatment. No screens and all, you used to get these audio systems at that time. Obviously, air conditioning control, storage space here, there, whatnot. The instrument cluster actually looks quite decent and it's a regular affair. I think it resembles some new Hyundai car as well. Can you guess which one? Steering is actually quite big. That's what she said. And you obviously don't get any mirror or stuff right there. You don't need it. There's a light placement in the center. There's none at the front, or probably it was there at the front. It's no longer there at the front. Let me get the key out so we can turn on the vehicle. And there is the key of the vehicle. So I'm just going to get into ignition. Obviously, this is a manual, so I have to clutch. There it rolls to life and makes some sound. Teet. These are the controls for the headlights, wipers, the usual bits. Simple, plain, basic car, which... Okay, radio, will you shut yourself and stop making sound? Like, who's talking to me at the moment? Hazard light switch buttons actually have this nice click to it, which is nice and impressive as well. I think we should just start driving. All right, we're all set to go. Let's turn on the car. It actually rose to life. This, oh my god, the gearbox is so smooth. It's absolutely butter smooth, which is kind of surprising. And then you say G-Wagon has this door locking mechanism. Well, this car also has it. It also makes this noise as if a gunfire is happening. Anyways, the suspension is super duper 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 soft. And I'm sitting so lower down. I feel really weird. I'm like, oh god, am I sitting on the floor by any chance? Because the car is really very, very, very low. Now, this is a 1.5 liter engine, which makes, I think, 91 or 95 horsepower. Nobody cares. And 123 Newton meters of torque. There was a 1.6 liter engine also, which came in the Accent GTX Tornado, which made 103 horsepower, slightly more torque. Again, nobody cared about it. However, what was the cool thing was, it also came with a diesel engine and it also came up with a notchback known as the Accent Viva, that had a super duper cool ad. Being a notchback, it had a rear wiper as well. I had a crush on it, the red colored car. Now, I had a crush on the Accent in my childhood because we had an S-Team which was golden colored, and not the neighbor, but the neighboring parking guy had a golden colored Accent which he recently bought. He also had a Premier Padmini. He used to really keep his car super duper clean and well maintained. And that dude's Accent GLS, not GLS, GLE, whatever that is. Okay, why does Hyundai take Mercedes naming into their variant lineup? That's kind of weird. Anyways, engine is very tractable and smooth, refined enough, but you know, it's more about low end and mid range performance. It has 12 valves, it's a SOHC unit. The 1.6 liter engine got DOHC, so it was one up in that regard. More performance, in fact, let's see what is the performance here into first gear. Red lines close to 7000 RPM, and mid range punch is actually quite nice. Yeah, I like the mid-range punch. It has decent amount of grunt in the mid-range. The price of this car was between 5 to 8 lakh rupees. In fact, it seems quite fun to drive. Steering wheel is very soggy. Suspension is super soft. Gives it a good ride, but overall, there's a lot of body roll. Compared to the S-Team just had better handling and was more fun to drive. But the S-Team also had a soggy sort of a steering wheel. The steering wheel, the way they used to configure the steering wheel in those times was completely different. The clutch is not the lightest as such, but the Accent really pulled on for a real long time. In fact, Hyundai over pulled it and then tried to give it to the police and donate it to them. That's the reason why in most Rohit Shetty films or even in Rajinikanth films, it's the Accent which unfortunately keeps blowing up, because obviously the value has declined dramatically. Now, high speed stability is not that great, because first and foremost, it doesn't really do that high speed. It does 160 kilometers per hour if you take all those guts and push it hard, but it's a easy car to drive. Only thing is the steering wheel is so big now, and even though the suspension is soft, over bad bumps it crashes through, which I can feel the suspension noise crashing through over bad bumps. But the gearbox is having makhan inside for sure. It's so smooth. It's at another level of smoothness. It's like unbelievable. I'm like, has it actually shifted or not? That is the level of smoothness on offer. Braking performance is fine. Actually, Hyundai's braking was very good in those times. Even the Santra used to have amazing brakes, because they used to use a different kind of disc only and brake pads, which used to take some time to actually heat up. So we're going to take a U-turn here, so I can show you the U-turn. Now, steering feels actually heavy. Why is the steering heavy? It doesn't make any sense to have a heavy steering as such. There, we take a U-turn into the gas. Come on, baby, into second gear. Let's see where it goes. It takes its own sweet time to rev, but then it gets a nice move on in the mid-range and then pulls strongly as well. Feels a little jerky when you go on and off throttle transitions, but for the most part, nobody really cared and complained about it, because this was not a car which was meant to put your pants on fire. But hey, we can do a wheel spin. Obviously, we can. Let's see how it goes here. Revving the motor. Rev still 6,000. Oh my God, it put the power down so well. Either it did that or I failed with the wheel spin. I'm very disappointed with myself today. But we're going to try once again. Here we are, hazard light on, just to tell people that we've stopped. And there, revving the motor, dump the clutch. No, baby, no, no wheel spin. That is the way this car actually puts the power down. Very smoothly, very nicely. And now you can obviously get one for cheap, because a lot of them are on sale as well. The Accent was replaced by the Verna, and we've got a few generations of the Verna in India. And then the Verna's USP was actually, it was same as the Accent, because the Verna is actually the Accent globally. Same cars, different names. How does that change anything? Nothing at all. But yeah, diesel was there in this car. There were multiple petrol engine options as well. But you know, this 1.5 is making as much power as today Hyundai's 1-liter turbo petrol engine is making. Actually, Hyundai turbo petrol engine is making 30% more power. So let's not go there. It's time to end. Thank you so much for I forgot one thing. When I say thank you so much for watching, I remember a person who has said this famous dialogue when he was reviewing the Accent on his show, which is Jeremy Clarkson on Top Gear. He even called this car as the Hyundai Accident, because it was that terrible. But I don't find it as terrible. I think it's decent. For that time, it was good enough. Only thing is, these Goras thing now, whatever cars, I mean, they should all be luxury cars. Bye-bye.